Hi, this is your friendly neighborhood librarian again, and thank you for joining me. So in this video, we're going to be going over one of my favorite databases, ScienceDirect. To get to ScienceDirect, we're going to go ahead and click on Databases under the Find section of the library website. Okay, and we're brought to the A to Z database list. If you click on All Subjects, you can actually see just the databases that are going to be relevant to a specific subject area. We could click on Engineering and Technology. Now it's listing in alphabetical order the various databases we've selected as best bets if you're in the engineering or technology field. And you're going to see ScienceDirect is there. Go ahead and click on it. If you're off campus, it's going to ask for your PNW username and password before giving you access to this database. If you're on campus, it should just come to this search window. All right, and in the box that says keywords, we're going to type in those keywords that we came up with in the keyword and search strategy video. If you haven't watched that yet, I would recommend viewing that first. So we have lightweight, regoliths, excavation. And just as a note, if you ever do spell anything wrong or find yourself getting zero results, check your spelling. Our databases will not correct it. Okay, and using those keywords, I have 37 results. This isn't bad. I like to get between 10 and 100, so 37 is a reviewable number for me. You can look at the titles and see if you're finding anything that seems useful to you. You can click on abstract and go ahead and get that summary of what the article is about before you decide to read it. So let's click on this title. I feel lucky. And after clicking on it, I am brought to this page here so we can read that entire abstract. You do have the title of the journal it's coming from, the volume, the year, the page count, and you're going to need this information when you are making your citation. This is the title of the article itself, and then we do have each of the authors listed here. Make sure you take note of that. You will need it again. All right, if we scroll down after reading the abstract, we are presented with keywords. Pay attention to those keywords. Use them to change up your search to find articles more similar to this one that are going to be useful to you. And ScienceDirect oftentimes lets you read the entire article in your browser. So if you do have the time, you could just go ahead and read that now. If you don't, however, which we're all pretty busy, you can go ahead and click on Download PDF, and it'll ask if you want to download just this article or if you want to download this article and the other ones that were present in this issue of the journal this time. I typically just go with this article. I know I want this one for sure. All right, and depending on your browser, it may open in another tab, another window, or it might just download that file. If you do want to hold on to this, make sure you save it to your flash drive, your hard drive, or email it to yourself. If we go back, now that I've looked at this article, ScienceDirect is telling me other articles people looked at that were also interested in this one. This can be a good idea to link into other things that might be useful. But for me, I wanted to focus on a mining robot that's going to space, so this may not be exactly what I was looking for. Can close that out. Another useful aspect of ScienceDirect is it does have recommended articles. And what it looks at are the keywords that you use to search, the keywords assigned to this article, and even what's been published in this journal to try and pull out about 6 articles that it thinks will be useful based upon what you're currently looking at. If you find yourself getting a little stuck and find a really great article, this can be a useful area to help you move on further. And now we're going to go ahead and go back and change up our search a little, see if we can find any other articles. Maybe you went through everything and you only found one that was useful. We're going to try getting rid of lightweight. We're going to just focus on regolith excavation at the moment. Okay, we get rid of that and you can click enter on your keyboard or the little search glass. And now we have 1,300 results. This can be great or terrible, depending on how you felt about the first set of results. I am excited that I'm now seeing the word lunar regolith because I do want to get off of Earth with this project. And I see planetary regolith here, so I'm feeling a little bit better about this already. Another way you could limit this down, since we do have so many, is by date. We have 2018, 2017, 2016. And for each one you check, it is now limiting the results to that. We could even limit it by what type of article it is. So your professor might say they want research articles and that you can use book chapters. This is where you could also limit that. This has been a quick, short introduction to ScienceDirect. If you do have any questions, please feel free to go ahead and contact the library, and we will help you get further into this.